What I'm about to show you was so magical that over 6 million people on Instagram just had to see this thing do this, and this, and this. Here at Robeytech, we have seen a lot of laptops, as well as a number of portable devices moonlighting as laptops. But I don't know if I've ever seen anything do what this thing does. Like I said, it's straight up magical, but what is it? Thanks to Best Buy and Lenovo, we got our hands on the beautifully designed 8th generation Lenovo Yoga Book 9i. Now, over the past few weeks, we've had our time playing with it here in the shop, traveling across the country with it, and just generally enjoying our experience with the latest entry into Lenovo's Yoga Book family. Everywhere, and I do mean everywhere we went, people asked about it. Just stunned by its majesty, and to be honest, I don't blame them. I just can't stop thinking about it. It's that cool. I almost guarantee if you walked into a classroom, a coffee shop, or even a boardroom with this thing, it would be an absolute showstopper. The Yoga Book 9i is a dual OLED display laptop that offers all of the flexibility you could ever want in a laptop, along with a number of cool extras. This all does come at a cost, but hold on, we're gonna talk about that a little bit later. Driving this marvel, despite the I and the 9 in the name, is Intel's Core i7-1355U. This 10-core CPU is built on Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake architecture. So it has a few different cores to work with, 2 performance or P cores and 8 efficient or E cores. The P cores have a turbo clock of 5 gigahertz, while the E cores max out at 3.7 gigahertz. The CPU is fed by 16 gigabytes of LPDDR5X RAM running at 6400 megatransfer. Now, that was a bit of a mouthful there, but there is something that I want to point out here. See, Raptor Lake CPUs can either utilize DDR4 or they can utilize DDR5. Instead of cutting a corner, Lenovo actually opted for the faster RAM to power this bad boy. Now, that isn't the only time they chose speed. When it comes to storage, the Yoga Book 9i comes equipped with a zippy fast 512 gigabyte Gen 4 based M.2 drive. Now, if you have never used one of these puppies, they can significantly reduce the time it takes to do things like move files or launch applications, or even the time it takes to actually boot your system. I mean, who wants to rot while waiting for the system to boot up? Now, when we tried to dig into the details of what specific drive the Yoga 9i was running, our system identified the drive as a Western Digital SN740. On paper, that drive has a sequential read speed of 5,000 megabits per second. Write speeds around 4,000. That isn't specifically advertised on Lenovo's site, so just be aware that your mileage may vary, but rest assured that that Gen 4 NVMe drive will not disappoint. Keeping things in the theme of speed, the Yoga Book 9i gives users ample connectivity with high-speed connections like Wi-Fi 6E, 3, Thunderbolt 4 with USB Type-C ports, and Bluetooth 5.1. Am I forgetting something? Oh, that's right, the displays. See, the Yoga Book i9 has not one, but 2 13.3-inch 2.8K OLED displays. To break it down, that is a resolution of 2880 by 1800, so not quite in the 4K territory, but higher than 1080p for full HD. Now keep in mind, we're not simply talking about an extra screen to tag along. This is a whole screen attached to another screen. So it's not like one of those portable monitors you sometimes carry around. Like, this thing is attached. You're not, well, I should be careful with that. I mean, I don't want to break it, but point is, it's connected. Now, driving these displays is Intel's integrated Iris Xe GPU. Now, we'll talk more about that in a minute, because these displays are just, well, they're just so fancy. Now, the panels themselves have a max brightness of 4,000 nits, making them so bright and crisp that they just want to make you reach out and touch them. And you should, because honestly, if you've never seen or touched an OLED display, it's gonna ruin your life forever. I mean, that seems kind of bad, but here's the deal. It's worth it. Just go to a Best Buy, watch your favorite movie on OLED, and you're done. Like, you never wanna use anything else. These touch-enabled displays open up worlds of possibilities. You can use the virtual keyboard and touchpad to tap, just like you should be tapping that like and subscribe button right now. Or you could slap down that beautiful Tidal Teal Bluetooth keyboard, like you slap that notification bell, while enabling a customizable widget HUD, or you can use Lenovo's third generation digital pen to sketch out some sweet Robeytech fan art. Like Robey Cat. Like Robey Cat fan. No, that should not have been in the script. Okay, Brian. All joking, but not joking aside, on top of this, the Yoga Book 9i is Intel Evo certified. Now, in case you missed our video, which you should watch right here, let me give you the too long didn't watch. This certification is Intel's way of assuring you, as the consumer, that the laptop does what it says it's going to do. There's no shenanigans, no underpowered components, and it passes all of Intel's tests to prove it. Trust me, watch the video, it'll make way more sense. But the point is, Intel Evo makes buying laptops way easier. When we started unboxing the Yoga Book 9i, we just kept finding surprise after surprise. Folio stand? Check. Bluetooth keyboard? Check. Stylus pen? Mouse? Did Lenovo ship this thing over in like Mary Poppins' handbag? It seemed like there was like no end to the extras. Seriously, go check out the video on Instagram. We're not even joking about how much stuff this laptop came with. As surprised as we were, we remembered this is a $2,000 laptop. It should come with all of those extras. But it wasn't just about the extras. The build quality, well, it's just breathtaking. The sleek design and build quality make you feel like no expense was spared when it comes to engineering. And it was surprising, especially for something as eloquent, but surprisingly sturdy. Don't get me wrong, I wouldn't want to drop this thing, but it doesn't feel like it's going to snap if you put it in your backpack the wrong way. So what's the user experience like? Now, once we finished unboxing and kind of staring at the Yoga Book 9i, we tried it out in a couple different scenarios. Now, if you saw our shorts here on YouTube, or our reels over on TikTok or over on Instagram, we used the Yoga Book to do some things like cloud-based gaming while video streaming on the second stream, and we also ran a recording session with a VTuber running on Discord for an ASUS activation. I mean, we put this thing through its paces really to try and see what it was actually capable of. This all happened on camera, but also off camera, we pushed it even further with a battery of different benchmark and tests. Now, right off the bat, we absolutely loved the versatility and freedom of using multiple displays and the fact that they are actually attached. For you multi-monitor desktop users, you know what I'm talking about. What's the first thing you miss on a mobile device? It's usually your second screen. But Lenovo doesn't stop there. The included digital pen and keyboard are absolutely awesome. And the options for using the keyboard, that's just some good soup. We mentioned this a bit earlier and showed it off in the intro, but it's worth talking about. Not only can you use both displays with the wireless keyboard separated from the Yoga Book, but when you attach the keyboard by setting it on the lower screen and you basically put it closer to you, it pulls up a heads-up display that you can customize with the information of your choosing. Now, when you slide the keyboard closer to where the screens actually meet, you'll actually activate a touchpad. Or you can do away with the wireless keyboard entirely and use the virtual one. Now, I know not everyone is going to be a fan of a virtual keyboard, but before you click away from the video, consider this. Now, while the virtual keyboard does take up a portion of one of the screens, you still have a whole other screen to work with. No more obscuring content or having to scroll up to see what horrible typo you just radically changed the meaning of your DM. Not only does Lenovo give you plenty of real estate to work with for the virtual keyboard, it also provides haptic feedback, which is nice and a little unnerving at first when you're touching a glass and it's like punching back at you. But it does take a little bit of getting used to, but it really did help with the overall typing experience. We did find that because the screens are multi-touch surfaces, users need to be mindful of where they basically have their wrists rest, lest you accidentally use a question mark instead of an exclamation point. You know, like that whole thing with comma save grandma, you know what I mean? Can we eat grandma or can we eat grandma? You know what I mean? Like it's amazing. You don't want to kill grandma, you sickos. Now, getting a bit more technical, when it comes to the power consumption, the Yoga Book 9i daintily sipped the energy while idle, running at an average of 4.34 watts. While under heavy load, the CPU was far more thirsty, increasing its average wattage to 17.89 watts. Okay, so this is actually an important piece of information that we'll talk about in a bit. So hang on to it, along with that whatever illustration you have in your head of like sipping wattage. You know, is 17 more than 4? Yes, it is. Now, when it comes to thermal performance, the Yoga Book stayed within a reasonable operating range, whether sitting at idle or even under heavy CPU load. At its highest, it only hit 70 degrees Celsius, but averaged out at about 68. That's still toasty, but not the over 90 degrees we saw on the desktop side of things. Now, while idling temps dipped down to 46 at the lowest, average ended up being around 50 degrees Celsius, not too bad, and it never got too hot to handle. No matter what Brian says, that is fine. Brian's like, that sounds really hot. It's not, it's a lie. It's fine, Brian. Now, when we started moving into actual performance, this is when we started discovering a few things that weren't quite as magical about the Yoga Book 9i. When it comes to battery life, the Yoga Book 9i advertises 7 hours worth of charge. On average, we found battery life to be a bit closer to 5 hours while actively being used on things like Discord calls. We did find that you could get around 6+ hours out of it if you weren't pushing it too hard. We had the Yoga Book running in the studio while working on some video production, occasionally being used to check email, browse on socials, or check on scripts. Anything more than that, though, significantly impacts battery life, and anything more is kind of the operative statement. Now keep in mind, this is without doing anything funky with settings like disabling a screen, turning off Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, or sticking your like left leg in a bucket of ranch dressing. I mean, the early days of tech, I mean, it was weird, man. I mean, we'd just try about anything twice if you could extend your battery life of a laptop. I mean, those things like barely held a charge. Here's the thing. All that being said, we still thought the battery life was actually really good. It just wasn't quite what we expected out of an Intel Evo certified laptop and didn't quite measure to where Lenovo said it was. Okay, so the next bit. I'm not gonna lie, it just makes me a bit sad. This laptop is not for gamers. In fact, it's not even for like super heavy application use. We found that the Yoga Book's pretty limited when we tried to run applications beyond like simple tasks. We started to see some sluggish behavior like cursor lag or Windows leaving behind ghosting trails as we tried to move them around. There is that whole pesky anything more issue again. So why is this happening? We think we have an idea. The Yoga Book 9i relies solely on the Core i7's integrated GPU with no dedicated system to offload otherwise GPU-bound tasks. So all of the system's processes rest on the CPU alone. Here's the deal, don't get me wrong, it's actually a really good CPU, but it can actually only do so much, especially when you look at the already low wattage the CPU's getting fed with. That's just a limitation of laptops. A dedicated discrete GPU would have helped the Yoga Book 9i in a very big way. We loved just about everything else about the Yoga Book, but we were just left wanting a bit more when it came to the overall performance. We just wish the power inside matched the beauty of what was on the outside. Does this spell doom for a laptop that has yet to hit the market? Or does it beg the question, who is this for? Who is the user who is going to be able to make the most out of Lenovo's Yoga Book 9i? We're a bit torn on this one. If you're looking for like a dual screen, portable gaming, on-the-go streaming setup, this isn't going to be for you. You could use it with a cloud streaming service like we did with Xbox Game Cloud. And if you're streaming games like Minecraft, Story Mode, it worked great. But we probably wouldn't use it to trust like in a Fortnite lobby, though, let's be honest, Fortnite, I mean. However, there are a couple cases where we think the Yoga Book 9i could be a one and done device. If you need quick access to a multiple full screen applications that don't require a ton of system resources, things like Excel, Outlook, I mean, this is a PowerBook device. The Yoga Book holds up pretty well. If you need to have reference material at a glance while writing or drawing, then this is a pretty compelling choice. If you're looking for a portable setup for like video chat while being able to access information like presentations or emails, then the Yoga Book 9i could be the secret weapon. This is perfect for heavy productivity tasks, and there are gonna be executives and producers and, you know, accountants and people like Matt, who you don't even know. This is the first time we've ever said his name, but it could be really good for him. Seriously? This is a statement piece. Coming in at $1,999 or near $2,000, there is a lot to consider here, especially when you look at the options within the price range. I mean, there's a lot of other great laptops you can get for $2,000. But what it really comes down to is you. What are you looking to get out of it? If you want to be a baller, this might be the perfect choice. At the end of the day, not every piece of technology is going to make sense to every user. regardless of whatever we were disappointed by, we still think that Lenovo's Yoga Book 9i is quite magical and that it has the capacity to make life a little bit easier for users who need multiple displays on the go and look good while doing it. If you're someone like me who's juggling communications and production or keeping my eyes on social, then the Yoga Book 9i has given me a lot more freedom in my personal workflow. Honestly, this thing has become a daily part of my personal tech regimen. The innovations that Lenovo nailed on the Yoga Book 9i make us want to see more devices like this in the marketplace. It would be amazing to see more options like this, but with just a little bit more power. Now, we hope this isn't the last we've seen out of Lenovo, but we want to know what you think. How would you use the Yoga Book 9i? Would you use a device like this, and what would it inspire you to do? We'd love to know all that and more down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a brand new video right here on Robeytech. We'd also love you to join our Discord channel, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's a great place to have discussions about not only the Lenovo Book 9i and everything else, but also to ask questions about laptops, PC builds, you name it. And you know what? You never know if you're going to make a friend. Big thank you to Best Buy and Lenovo for getting us the opportunity to check out the Yoga Book 9i. We hope you enjoyed this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.